Okay, welcome to everyone. We'd like to wish everyone a joyful Rastafari Hanukkah, and this day for the record is November 28th, 2013. Now, before we begin this presentation that we already previously titled, and it's Rastafari Hanukkah, Maccabees, and Relivication. The Relivication of the True Temple of the Almighty. Before we begin with that, we'd like to encourage ones to support and check out on the YouTube channels. Wenda Mandela has recently opened or started a channel. Support that channel and check it out. Game Amp Me by Sistrin Emmanuel Emmanuel. Tewahedo 1000, that's Rastafari custom music. Be sure to check that out, support our brother. And Word Sound Power Manifest, very good video presentations. And Biruku One, which very good presentations as well. That's our personal opinion. And on the Facebooks, be sure to visit and keep up to date with EthiopianWorld.net so that ones are updated and informed as to what kind of projects our brother Tobia is working on. Wendem Tobia always has some good stuff going on, so be sure and keep up to date with that. And WordPress, as far as WordPress pages go, let us not forget that we can keep up to date with our Senbet studies, Shabbat studies. Logging on to Rastafari Renaissance.wordpress. Lij Yefti, give thanks for that. Rastafari Talmud or Rastafari Midrashim. Also on the WordPress, be sure support and check that out. That is, give thanks to Wendem Jason. And last but not least, Melik Media House. On the WordPress, which is the motivation for this presentation. We just recently read an article, and it had to do with some of the stuff that we were meditating on. And so, as a result, here we are. So now let us begin. Rastafari Hanukkah, Maccabees, Relivication. This will be kind of like three parts. First part is God Our Weapon. Second part, the tricolor order, which would fall under the subject of the covenant. And part three would be when we return, the prophecy, the promise. And so we'll begin by reading from My Life and Ethiopia's Progress, Volume 1, the autobiography of Emperor Haile Selassie I, and we're gonna go forth to page 236, and it reads: It cannot be doubted that a soldier, a peasant, or a trader, his country's independence. Okay, forgive me. We're gonna actually try that again. It cannot be doubted that to a soldier, a peasant, or a trader, his country's independence is his greatest pride. It is therefore important to convince you to the utmost extent possible that quarrels and deceitfulness amongst you should disappear, that love and unity should spread, and that a servant should acknowledge obedience to his master and a soldier to his officer. If the Italians are proud of their weapons against us, we on our part, this is the key sentence. If the Italians are proud of their weapons against us, we, on our part, are proud that our greatest weapon against them is the help of God. So this falls under the first part, which would be God, our weapon. In God, we do trust, And so going forth, this is another key sentence. Our flag, red, yellow, and green. And our seal. So our flag, red, yellow, and green, would be fall under the tricolor order and the covenant. And actually continuing, and our seal with the legend, the lion hath prevailed. That would fall under the category, the part, third part, which would be when we return, the prophecy, the promise. Okay, we're gonna read that again. If the Italians are proud of their weapons against us, we on our part are proud that our greatest weapon against them is the help of God, our flag red, yellow, and green, and our seal with the legend, the lion hath prevailed, are the symbol of our independence. Lest the symbol of our freedom should perish, it is a great honor for our good name and for our history if we die shedding our blood to the very last drop. That would actually be concerning the covenant. Let's see, we have no real idea as to how we're gonna go about that. Well, to bring this together, but let's just go to the footnote. When it makes mention red, yellow, and green, there's a footnote to it, and the footnote reads, "This order, instead of the usual green, yellow, red, is curious for us. While there was for long uncertainty about the sequence of these colors, this was scarcely so in 1935." So now we're actually going to go forward to page 237. Excuse me. All right, continuing, we actually had to pause that. It wasn't the page. The page we were intending to go forward to is page 221. It reads here, "We shall strive for peace till the end, but even if our exertions and our goodwill have not achieved any result, at least our conscience will not reproach us. The Ethiopian people, united in faith, stretches out its hand to God, that he may strengthen the power of our valiant men truly to defend our country's independence." Now that is directly connected with Psalm 69. If one's care to go forward to that. And now we just kind of like glance through this, and we're gonna spontaneously add another portion of reading, and this is going to be page 231. And it reads, "I would be very distressed if we were to be thought of as being defeated. Therefore, people of my country Ethiopia, help me. You who have strength with your strength, you who lack strength with your sympathy. The reason for which you are to help with strength and with sympathy is that you know it to be for the sake of your religion and your freedom, for your emperor, who in mutual thought and assistance is like a father and like a son, and for the sake of your flag, which proudly manifests independence." And we'd actually like to include to this that throughout this reasoning, to keep in mind the spirit, the fighting spirit of the Maccabees, for that is the sole purpose to this presentation, that we must relivocate our bodies as the temple of the Most High and partake in this spirit of courage and make manifest this fighting Ethiopian spirit of ours. You know, we must be willing to die, we must be willing to shed our blood for the for you know for keeping our banner up on high, that is a symbol of our independence, and the banner itself indicates our triumph. So if we put our trust in him most I surely in covenant, the triumph will come to pass. But we must overcome death. As soon as we overcome death and lose the spirit of fear, which was not given to us, then we will approach the matter in the style of willing to die for what is true. And we've said this to particular individuals, if you're willing to die, then you already won, because they cannot take that which is of you, for you're willing to sacrifice your life for that which is true, and there is no defeat in that. So we must be willing to fight this war to the death. When the enemy is able to visualize or see that we are willing to die, the enemy will flee, for they have nothing to gain but their own destruction. And so we must revive that spirit, and only then will we rise up in judgment and make the enemies, our enemies, the enemies of Jesus Christos, Yeshua HaMashiach, our footstool. You know, we've been given the example in His Imperial Majesty, but we too must overcome. So, and actually, this is, now that we went forward and read that, and or actually spoke that, it's a good time to go to New Testament, the Gospel of John, chapter 15. Basically, what we were trying to say, you can't defeat someone that's willing to die. And people will think twice to mess with an individual of that type. As soon as we as Rastafari get our acts together and be willing to take part in the covenant, the blood covenant, then surely we shall overcome and be triumphant. So now, the world is waiting on us, really. No one else is going to set the example, because no one else has any living. No one else does worship that which they do see, they do touch, they do know. So no one else is going to have any kind of motivation or spiritual uplift to make manifest those things which are written, except for we that do know the Almighty, the living Word, you know, and the manifestation of Christ in His kingly character, you know. So John 15, verse, I mean, the whole chapter is pretty good, but, you know, just to keep this short, we're going to begin with verse 10. If ye keep my commandments, so this would be under the second part, the tricolor order and the covenant. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in His love. These things have I spoken to you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Ye are my friends if ye do whatsoever I command you. So we must be willing, as did He, to sacrifice, to be a living sacrifice, to sacrifice ourselves for our brothers and sisters, if truly we do love each other as we claim to do so. And if truly we are to keep His commandments, which were given to Him by our Father, you know? So, okay, going forward. Now, this, we think it's, next part would be the prophecy. This is actually page 237. Reads here. Well, we're going to begin from the whole, I guess, the start of the chapter. Lest the airplane, when rising again, should detect the whereabouts of those who are dispersed, it is well to remain cautiously scattered as long as it is still fairly close. In time of war, it suits the enemy to aim his guns at adorned shields, ornaments, silver and gold cloaks, silk shirts, and all similar things. Whether one possesses a jacket or not, it is best to wear a narrow-sleeved shirt with faded colors. Now, this is the reason we read this is because His Imperial Majesty is who He is. This is all planned, you know. The reason we're all scattered is because we're gonna go to another reference. Hold on. All right, continuing. Okay, we had to pause it again because we had to look this up. So now, this is from the wise mind of Emperor Haile Selassie I. He leads us into battle. So everything that's within my life and Ethiopia's progress is actually an instruction for us. If we can receive the spiritual, then we'll be quick to make connect those dots and link that to our battle that in which we are in to this very day. Now, okay, it reads here, it is a sound tactic of military strategy to attack where your opponent's defense is weakest. It is surely sound strategy for all of us to move ahead where such movement is unobstructed and unimpeded. So basically what we're trying to say is that when the autobiography of His Imperial Majesty states that should detect the whereabouts of those who are dispersed, that's us. That is in fact the reason why we have been dispersed throughout the four corners of the earth, so that such movement cannot be obstructed and impeded, so that we have versatility, flexibility, and thus the enemy cannot track us down, really, because, you know, it's kind of impossible to figure out where it even is that we're at. We're not a concentrated force to which in a position in which a single bomb could exterminate us. So we're strategically positioned throughout the world. And so now going forward, the whole adornments and stuff like that, we all look different. They can't tell one from another, you know. And that jacket, it reminds us of the coat of Joseph. You know, it could very well be that's why Jah, in his bigger plan, in the bigger picture, he had his brethren take that coat from him, so that, you know, during a time of war, so that he's not easily spotted. So now continuing, even now that just came to mind, that could even very well explain the shades of color within Rast Eferi, including all peoples within the human community. You know, how can you tell one from another? It's great warfare is what it is. So it says here, when we return, this is the prophecy, if we are able to keep God as our weapon, if we are able to make manifest the tricolor order, the covenant, keep covenant, then we will return and thus fulfill prophecy and you know, receive promise. It reads here, when we return with God's help, His Imperial Majesty is still in Ethiopia at this point. So he's making mention, when we return, you can wear your gold and silver decorations then. Now it is time to go and fight. We offer you all these words of advice in the hope that no great harm should befall you through lack of caution. So this whole presentation, the motivation is on Melek Media House, because in one of the articles, we don't even remember the whole like information, but there was a I guess like within the article, there was an article that someone had previously posted, and it made mention that Haile Selassie first had predicted or prophesied exactly the time that he would depart from his country of Ethiopia, saying that in 5 years I will return. Now this, it doesn't confirm it to the fullness, but it does bring to light the fact that he was aware that his departure was inevitable and that his return was, you know, as well inevitable. So, because, you know, His Majesty knew all of this. So now let us actually try to break this down, or kind of like put it together rather. We don't want no breaking down. So, okay, God is our weapon. For this, we'll go to 2 Samuel chapter 22, verse 35. This is concerning the Song of David, of deliverance. So now, we're only going to go to one verse, chapter 22, David's Song of Deliverance, verse 35. He teacheth my hand to war, so that a bow of steel is broken by mine arms. Steel representing hardness, broken by our arms. We must be able to break the hardening of our hearts and submit ourselves to Jah Almighty. We must surrender to Him. And By doing so, the enemies of Christ, our enemies, shall surrender to us. It's the way it works. But first, we must give it all up to Him. And so, continuing, now it looks like it would be a good time to kind of explain the graphics or the pictures, the drawings. In the Bible and in old times, when one would hang their bows on the wall and they would be upside down, that would be a signification, a symbol of war, a time of war. So now, as for that footnote, that for a long time it had been kind of unclear, but as far as 1935, it was really clear the order of the tricolors within the flag. Here's the answer to that. In a time of war, the bow is bent down, as one can see as depicted in the image. Thus, red, yellow, and green. In a time of peace, the troops, the soldiers, would come home and hang their bows on the wall. Pointing up. Thus, kind of like the rainbow when we see it, made manifest, after a rainy day. So, the order of that would be green, yellow, and red. So it is obvious that in a time of war, red is in the bottom, yellow, and then green. In a time of peace, we have green in the bottom, yellow in the middle, and red on top. This goes together with the bow that was showed Noah. This is the bow of the covenant. This is the sign. And so, actually, a broken bow would signify the surrender. So if ones would have a broken bow on the wall, then that would signify that they have surrendered to their enemies. Now, like David said, Jah teacheth our hands to war, so that we break a steel bow, but not surrender to the enemy, but surrender to the Almighty, you know? And so going forward, as far as once we surrender to Jah, once we overcome our hardening of heart, then we are flexible like a bow, and we can be bent and shaped and formed to the liking, to the likeness and image of our Creator, you know. And so so basically that allows us to enter into covenant, this covenant of law, in which we willingly wish to keep order, you know, keep covenant. And you know, the tricolor is the beginning of the seven manifestations of the color, which represents Sheba, fulfillment, order, law, oath, you know. And so thus representing keeping the covenant. So we put our trust in Him. As a result, we enter covenant, we are in law, and by keeping in law, by keeping covenant, then the prophecy, then we return the manifestation of the promise come to pass. And so let us go on forward. Just to conclude, we have lights. We light the candles on the lampstand, excuse me. We light the lamps. We liken this, if ones have kept up to date as with Brother Yadon's presentations, then the image or the depiction of how we have a man with his hands down is similar to the lampstand. And that would, so an individual with his hands down would be signifying a time of peace. Next to that, we have Ethiopia stretching her arms to the Most High. We have us in a state of war. as we can, if we can kind of like make a likeness between the war bow and the stretching forth our hands, then we could kind of see that similarity. But what we are trying to make mention here is that our shield and the shield of David, it is not necessarily the Star of David or an actual shield. It is the fulfillment, the completion of the oath, of the law, the promise. Jah is our protection. If we keep covenant, then that is our shield, and this is real. We're not sure if we've explained this before, but in if we explain it scientifically, falsely so-called, in the field of magnetism, when one is able to maintain integrity and keep straight with the universal principalities and laws that govern life, then a real force field begins to make manifest around us, a shield. And as long as we are shielded by truth and right, then there is no imp nothing can penetrate that, for the laws of existence would not allow that to be so. If our shield of David, as we recognize it, if this magnetism, this force field, some representations in different studies would relate this to an aura, and in the sense of magnetism, this would be the force that surrounds the body and thus repels anything that is contrary to the vibrational field within the magnetic forces that surround you. And so this is very true. If ones could kind of just, I'm sure some individuals can relate to an instance where you're just standing there, and there's kind of like wrong coming your way, and just they're just blocked from your position. Something happens, but they just get redirected. Or just someone sees you and just takes off for whatever reason, because they are repelled magnetically to that which they cannot harmonize to. If one can harmonize to lower vibrations, then they can attract wickedness and maliciousness. And so this is very true. Okay, let us go forward. We don't want to dwell on that. So now the concluding representation is the covenant. That rock, what is the rock? We liken the rock into the Ark of the Covenant, because it is a seat, a resting place. And the reason we make mention of that is because it reminds us of Moses when he was becoming tired. So if we're not mistaken, it was Aaron and Hur that placed a rock beneath him so that he could sit down. We liken that to the Ark of the Covenant, the mercy seat. And then Aaron and Hur helped him keep his hands stretched forth to the Almighty, sustained, in that principle, so that the Israelites would be what's it called, triumphant, would prevail over the enemy. So if we put that all together, and so it just makes perfect sense, is all we're trying to say. So our covering, our protection, our greatest weapon is the Most High. If we submit and humble ourselves to Him, allow the exemplary life of Jesus Christos to direct us, guide us, and teach us the way, and if we follow in that path, keeping covenant, then the eventual result is our return to the promise, the prophecy fully filled, the completion, the Sheba, and with that pretty much. Oh, and well, connecting all that to Maccabees and the relivication, we must relivicate the temple of the Almighty. We must have a change of mind and relivicate our obedience to that good influence, and thus, and thus make manifest all that which we spoke of. So we are the light. Jesus Christos is the initiate light. He gives light to us. We become light as well. And it all makes perfect sense. So Rastafari Hanukkah, may all have a joyful festival of lights, and let us receive the spirit of Maccabees. You know, we don't know a whole lot about Maccabees, but we do know that Maccabees was that point when some faithful said, "That's it. We're not going to take no more. We don't give up if we die. We're sick and tired of this. So we must take on that spirit once more, as Rastafari for." You know, when the Miyadon said there'll never be peace in the Middle East in that so-called state of Israel, because they are not of Israel. They cannot be these people whom it is only us. If we have to stand up and decide to fight and be willing to show our love to our brothers and sisters within the human community by sacrificing our lives, you know, and fearing nothing. So with that, we give thanks to all, and shalom be with I and I.